Okay, children, in my previous lecture, I have discussed the question number 1, right? Which was where the quadratic polynomial was given to us and we got the solution for the quadratic polynomial, that is the number of zeros of the quadratic polynomial. Now see, question number 2, there is a reverse question. Here, sum of the zeros and the product of zeros are given. Sum of zeros for the quadratic polynomial we have assumed as a suppose alpha beta. So alpha plus beta and alpha into beta value is given. And we have to make the quadratic polynomial. Clear? In question number 1, quadratic polynomial was given. And we got the value of zeros, that is alpha beta. Here, sum of the zeros, that is alpha plus beta and alpha into beta value is given. And we have to make the quadratic polynomial. That means it is the reverse of the question number 1. Clear? Now see. First value, according to the question, NCERT question, the first value is sum of zeros. Sum of zeros means alpha plus beta is given 1 by 4. And second value is product of zeros, that is alpha into beta, that is given minus 1. So you have to make the quadratic polynomial. So I had given the direct formula to make the quadratic polynomial. Polynomial in x term, k in curly bracket, you write x square minus sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta into x plus product of zeros, that is alpha into beta. So this is the formula to make the quadratic polynomial with the help of the given zeros, that is the solution for the quadratic polynomial. Now simply you put the value, you will get your answer. Here, x square minus, first value is sum of 0, that is 1 by 4, so alpha plus beta, this alpha plus beta is replaced by 1 by 4 of x plus alpha into beta value is given minus 1. Right children? Now see, here x, we got x square minus 1 by 4x plus or minus 1, right? Now, you can take the 1 by 4 out of the curly bracket, so that will convert it into the constant. When you take the 1 by 4 out, that is the common for this curly bracket, since 1 by 4 is not available in all the 3 terms of the given this polynomial. But still we are taking 1 by 4 out to make it in standard form, that is straight form, right? So what you do, the denominator value is 4, you multiply with the 4 in whole term, that is all the 3 terms of the given polynomial inside the bracket, so it becomes 4x square minus x plus or minus plus 4, right? Why we did this? So the value of this given expression should not be changed. Now see, when you open the bracket, you will get the same thing. 1 by 4 into 4, 4 4 cancel, you will get x square. 1 by 4 into x, you will get 1 by 4x. 1 by 4 into minus 4, 4 4 cancel, you will get minus 4. So the value should not be changed. So further you will write here, since we are, k is replaced by 1 by 4, since k is equal to 1 by 4, therefore polynomial, required polynomial will be the 4x square minus x minus 4. So this is the required polynomial for the given sum of zeros and product of zeros, that is 4x square minus x minus 4.